persons to release your blessing. All of them went for baptism in that service. They were baptized, they came casually. That's why we don't hear of them. But the Bible says that Jesus also came praying. Hallelujah. He also, while the others came casually, he came praying. And as he was praying, what happened? The heavens were open and a dove came down. And Jesus was distinguished from the others. Why? Because he made up his mind that others may think it is just baptism, but I came to gain something from heaven. I came to provoke my open heavens. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So it is not that you are here tonight, but it is, what is your intention for this service? What is your expectation for this service? What have you said before you came to this service? Some of you may have said, Lord, do not pass me by tonight. Others may have said, I am just going to fulfill all righteousness. Going back to our verses for meditation, all of them came to be baptized. Some of them came casually, I've said already, to fulfill all righteousness. And the Bible said Jesus came praying. So why others came to the baptism, to the church service, casually, with no expectation, with nothing tied around their waist, expecting to see nothing. They just came because they thought it was a normal ritual. Jesus said, not so. I am going for open heavens. Jesus, on the other hand, came with a prayerful perspective. So how you come to church determines what comes to you. How you come to church determines what follows you home. And what you do with the principle given you in church after you leave determines your speed in life. Every month we run on series and we say, to be this, you have to do this. 99.9% of us don't go back and do anything about it. We give principles, we give bullet points, we give you why and how you can get to what the theme of the month is talking about. We tell you the principles that are required to provoke your blessing that month. 99.9% of us don't apply one of those principles. Shall Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Yeah, shouting is not good enough.
Lord have mercy.
Acts 17:11, let's read. It says, Acts 17:11. It says, these were more noble than those in the Thessalonica. It says, in that they received the word with all readiness of mind and they searched the scripture. Who were they? The Berean Christians. They were more noble. Why? Because they came to church, they gave them the principles, they went back home, they searched the principles, they applied the principles, and when God is saying they were more noble, it means blessings follow them as they follow the principles.
Amen.
So it is not only in the hearing, but it is in the doing. Say never. Are you a hearer or a doer? Don't talk to that one. Talk to the other one. That one is not listening. Say never. What did they answer? What did they say? Child of God, one thing you must understand is that God does not open heavens for everybody. God does not open heavens for every. That is why you can see two people are praying for the same thing. Before you open your eyes and close, one person has already received. The other one is still waiting. Many of the time it's character. Shout,
oh Lord.
Search me tonight.
Anything you see in me
that is not of you, take it away. Open your mouth, pray that prayer. Like us to pray that prayer. In your seated position, pray that prayer. Thank you, my Father. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Let us read Dethrone Your Enemies 28:23-24. If you are there, Dethrone Your Enemies 28:23-24. And what does it say? Dethrone your enemies. 23:3-1, go. Let's read. It says, and the heavens that is over the head shall be, and that is under thee shall be. Verse 24, what does it say? It says, the Lord shall make the rain of the land powder and dust. From heaven shall it come down upon thee until thou be destroyed. So that tells you that every man has a personal responsibility to determine the speed of their open heavens. Hallelujah. And it's your open heavens that determines the flow and the speed of your blessings. I prophesy after now, you will go home with open heavens in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Shout, oh Lord,
oh,
open up my heavens tonight. Even Jesus had to pray, child of God, for his heavens to be opened. Mark 1:10, it says, Mark 1:10-12, it says, and straight away coming up out of the water, he saw what their heavens opened, and the Spirit like dove descending upon him, and there came a voice from heaven. So as soon as his heavens opened, he heard a voice. As soon as it is momentum non-entity, I don't know how to put it, for a child of God not to hear God. It is irresponsibility of the spiritual class for a child of God not to hear. As I'm speaking now, I'm hearing it.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Some people say, I don't really want to say, God said, you are not, you don't, if you don't hear, you don't hear it. Just leave it. You are not hearing it. Hallelujah. The Bible says, as soon as his heavens were open, what happened? He heard a voice. And let's read the next part. This is not really what I want to teach. Next, let me say, and he heard a voice saying, thou art my beloved son, in whom I'm well pleased. And verse 12 says, and immediately the Spirit driven him into there. And God began to tell me, as soon as the heavens were open, he provoked his heavens. What happened? Now he heard a voice. And that voice gave him direction. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Even Jesus knew that without open heavens, he would fail in ministry, sir. Jesus knew that without open heavens, he would fail blatantly in ministry. You will not fail in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I don't like that amen at all.
Amen.
So you must understand, child of God, for any man to succeed on earth, his heaven has to be open first. So until your heavens are open, your heavenly blessing cannot manifest speedily. Until your heavens are open, your earth will be closed. That will not be your story in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Ask yourself, why would a graduate go to university and get a master degree and get a PhD, but no jobs are, the heavens are closed? Ask yourself, why would a woman who is ready to get married, why would a man who is ready to get married, no one wants to marry him? His heavens are closed. Ask yourself, why would a woman be in marriage for 6 years, no child? The heavens are closed. After this encounter, your heavens open in the name of Jesus. Your amen is looking for my trouble.
Amen.
I came tonight in the name that is above every other name. I prophesy any power blocking your open heaven, I command them to scatter. 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 Anywhere they are gathered, in the air, in the land, in the sea, I command them to scatter.
Jesus.
In Malachi 3:10, let's read. Malachi 3:10. Are you there? It says what? Let's read together. 3, 2, 1, go. Bring. Even your voice has reduced. It concerns money. Your voice is gone. Your voice is gone because it concerns money. Malachi 3:10. 3, 2, 1. Let's read.
Bring your heart.
a yes and amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Sir, all over the Bible, that's the only place where God says, test me and see. As you bring the tithe, ask him, Lord, he said, test me and see.
Amen.
That is the only place in the Bible that God said, as the tithe abroad, I will open your heaven. It is a spiritual transaction. It is automatic. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that literally means that God will not pour down blessings in your life unless your tithe abroad. God will not pour down blessings. Many of us, we operate a mediocre life. God is saying, I will open up the heavens and rain you. You know what it means to rain you a blessing? I'll rain you a blessing that your storehouse will not be able to contain more. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ezekiel 1:1. What does it say? Ezekiel 1:1. Let's read together quickly. It says, moreover, the Spirit lifted me up. Ezekiel 1. Now it came to pass. Yes, that's right. The 30th, in the fourth month, in the fifth day of the month, as I was among the captive by the river of Sheba, that the heavens were open, and I saw visions of God. Son of God, you want to see visions? Provoke your heavens. Hallelujah. Provoke your heavens. Let's read again. 2 Kings 7:2. Quickly. 2 Kings 7:2. Quickly. We need to get off here by 5 o'clock. By 10 o'clock. 2 Kings 7:2. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's read. Are we there? 2 Kings 7:2. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. It says, then a Lord on whose hand the king leaned answered the man of God and said, behold, if the Lord will make windows in heaven, might this thing be? And he said, behold, thou shalt see it with the eyes, but shall not eat thereof. Verse 3. Read verse 3. What does it say? Now what happened there literally is they were in the midst of famine. 3.5 years in famine and everything looked rough. Literally people were killing their babies and eating them. That's how bad. So you may just sit at home, your wife just cuts your neck and say, this is you for food today. That's how bad the famine was. And Elijah was walking with a servant, and he said to the servant, by this time tomorrow, there will be so much food. And the servant said, even if the heavens are open, I don't think that will be possible. And what happened? Did it happen or not? It happened because the word of a prophet went forth. And famine ceased by word. That means when your heavens are open, famine automatically ends. After tonight, your famine ends in the name of Jesus. Whatever represents famine in your career, I put an end to in the name of Jesus. In your business, it ends in the name of Jesus. In your marriage, it ends in the name of Jesus. According to the word that has come for tonight, your famine is terminated in the name of Jesus. Does not matter your affliction, sir, ma. Every wilderness experience will dry up this month in the mighty name of Jesus. I prophesy any famine in your life is hereby terminated in the name of Jesus. Quickly, we say, if you must enjoy open heavens, you must provoke open heavens. Number one, how do I provoke my open heavens? It is clear from the verses. He said, Jesus came praying. The others came casually, and he made a difference. So you provoke your open heavens by effectual fervent prayer. James 5:16, let's read. James 5:16 says, confess your fault one to another, and pray one for another, and pray one for. He didn't say backbite one. He didn't say talk against one. He says pray for one. Hallelujah. And pray one for another that he may be healed. It says the effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. Again, ask yourself, child of God, how did that heavens by prayer. How did Elijah provoke his heavens by prayer? How did Moses? Those are men that prayed 40 days. No water, no food. Hallelujah. Even Jesus knew that for him to succeed in ministry, in life, he needed to operate under open heavens. The heavens were not open for Jesus because he was a son of God. The heavens were open because he prayed. He prayed. He prayed, sir. He prayed. Shout hallelujah. James 5, 17, 18. Let's read. It says, Elijah was a man subject to like passion as we are. And he prayed what? Are we here tonight? This is all you get though. And the prophetic declaration I made. And the washing of it. Hallelujah. So if you are waiting for something else, you wait and wait and wait some more. Hallelujah. It says, Elijah was a man subject to like passion as we are. And he prayed earnestly that it might not rain. And it rained not on the earth by the space of 3 years and 6 months. Verse 18, what does it say? It says, and he prayed again. Child of God, how many times did you pray today? And he prayed again. He prayed until something happened. He prayed until he had answers to his prayers. And he prayed again. And the heavens gave rain and the earth brought forth her fruits. So you have not prayed enough until you get answers to your prayers. Say never. You have not prayed enough until you get answers to your prayers. God does not answer to tears. Go and begin to cry. You are defeated. Pack your load. You are defeated. Hallelujah. Amen. God never answers to tears. God answers to fervent, effectual prayer. What do I mean by that? Consistent prayer. Lord, I will not let you go until you bless me. Lord, I will not let you go until you change my story. Enough is enough. How long, oh Lord? Hallelujah. Amen. Until you see answers to your prayers, you have not prayed enough. That should tell you that you can never operate under open heavens without taking deliberate steps to pray consistent, fervent prayers in your life. The truth remains, child of God, that there are prayers I can pray for you. I've said that again. That there are prayers you must pray for yourself. There are prayers I can pray for my children. There are prayers they have to pray for themselves. Right now, we teach them to pray. You want to eat, pray. You don't pray, no food. Simple as that. Amen. Train a child the way he should grow, so that when he grows, he will not depart from them. When they are in a group tomorrow, they put poison in the food. He will say, I bless this food in the name of Jesus. Others may eat and go. But the one that has been trained to pray will remain blessed. Hallelujah. Poison will turn to vitamins. When next they set a trap for you, he that set a trap for you, I prophesy, they will fall inside the name of Jesus. I said they will fall inside the name of Jesus. The disciples asked Jesus, teach us how to pray. Jesus simply said, if you want to pray, just say, my Father who is in heaven, hallowed be Daniel. They expected Jesus to open a school for them. They expected Jesus to hold a Bible study class. They expected Jesus to hold a Bible training course to teach them how to pray. But Jesus said, simply say, my Father. That is why many churches have missed God, because of the Lord's Prayer, they think that's prayer. Those prayers were just guidelines to tell you how to pray. Many have missed God because now that has become a recitation for them. They don't know the person of Jesus. That will not be said of us in the mighty name of Jesus. I don't like that amen at all. Psalms 81:10, as we round up, it says, I am the Lord that God which brought thee out of the land of Egypt. It says what? Open thou the mouth wide and I will fill it in. So you must make up your mind to carry that long-awaited testimony must come to pass via this 91 days prayer and fasting.
Amen.
You must make up your mind that I must must celebrate me. Child of God, he must be on the altar of prayer. And when I say prayer, I don't mean 20 minutes prayer, and then you make a sign of the and go to sleep. You just wasted your fasting. You wasted your time. Just go and pack food and eat. Sit down, please. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I prophesy this month starting now. I am so positive about this month. Some of the things we'll see starting this month, it will be mind-blowing for some of you in the name of Jesus. This month starting now, let the baptism of prayer fall upon you in the name of Jesus. I don't like that. Amen at all. Why do you think a lot of people are being manipulated out of their marriages? Because they do not pray fervently. Sir, we read that Jesus prayed and his heavens were opened and he heard the voice of God. Now, a woman gets into a marriage for 10 years or 12 years. One day she herself, by herself, for herself. She packs her bag herself, for herself. She comes out of the house herself, for herself. She goes back to her father's house. Say error. Total error. Manipulated out of their jobs. Manipulated out of their businesses. Say, maybe this is not the will of God. I came to prophesy. That thing that makes you give up at the age of miracle, I command it to scatter by fire. 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 I command it to expire. In the name of Jesus. Sit down, please. And whenever you do not pray fervent effectual prayer, the devil will help you to make senseless excuses as to give you another assignment to hang around with those who are not, they are not worthy to hang around with. Hey, woman, okay, I have 5 children, so I cannot pray. Error. Susanna Wesley had 19 kids. And the Bible and the book I read says she prayed at least 1 hour in tongues. That was just in tongues. So we don't know what she did in the physical. 19 on her own. Her husband was always traveling preaching. 19 children. So you don't have an excuse. Many say, I don't have time. Oh, yes, when you wake up in the morning, your phone is your timetable. You take your phone and you are hanging on it 3 hours, typing what is not typing you, tweeting your life away on your phone. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Some of us need deliverance from the phone. After now, some of your phones will be missing in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
You may not answer, it will happen. I only wish you come and give testimony. Sir, have you, me and you, have we ever talked for more than 10 minutes? No, tell me, true. I told my back. And when we talk, we even talk non-personal thing. No, sir. It has to be kingdom advancement chats. What are you chatting with a non-entity that knows nothing about prayer? Someone who cannot add any value to your life, and yet you are going through problems that need urgent attention. Emergency 999. Go and pray. 2 a.m., 3 a.m. while others are praying, you are up chatting. Would people have known that anybody that is chatting with you at 2, 3 a.m., they have no direction? Yesterday, I came back from service at what time, maybe 10 o'clock, had to put the children to bed. And from 10 o'clock till this morning, 7:30, Malie Kaka. And you think my level will be the same with any other person who slept? It's not possible. It's not possible. I took the children to school. I came back again. Lakia Katia. Malay Kaka. 2 o'clock again. Like Ella. He called me and said, sir, no call today. I am on the altar of prayer.
Amen.
Put on that phone. Whenever you want to read your Bible, your phone is ringing. That is demonic. Put it off. That's why, sir, when I'm praying, you call me sometime. You wait. Keep saying I'm busy. That's your problem. As for you, I know where you go. Then my God liveth. He said, I will never leave you nor forsake me. Forsake you. Men will leave you, but God, as long as you have that connection, he will never leave you.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What you want me to pray for you when you are calling me on the phone is what I have to receive from him. So if you want me to pray for you and I'm praying that he should give me the answers to give you, And you have many people, they complain and complain and complain themselves to the wilderness. Say, Pastor, you are so busy. Once I see your call, I've already prayed for you. Just go and sleep. It's done.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say, according to the measure of their faith, it shall be done unto them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Isaiah 66:8. Let's read quickly as we round up and we do our anointing service. Isaiah 66:8. What does it say? Isaiah 66:8. It says, who had heard such things? It says, who has seen such things? It says, shall the earth be made to bring forth in one day? It says, or shall a nation be born at once? It says, for as soon as Zion travel how? In prayers. It says, she brought forth her children. So if you have not prayed enough, you cannot traverse her. A woman who is in the pregnancy ward, ready to give birth, she does not give up when the baby is about to come out. So she pushes even more. Baby, come out. Many of you, at the end of your miracle, that is when a confused one who is not going anywhere will come and distract you with a phone call. Hallelujah. There are levels of prayer, sir. When you are praying, it's like you're climbing a mountain. You know what I mean? It's like you're climbing. When the enemy knows that you're about to get to your open heavens, they stop you. They can use anyone. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They can use anyone. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout
glory.
As soon as Zion traveled, she brought forth her children. In other words, the husband, the wife, can be changed if there is a man to pray. Child of God, when prayers tarry, revivals tarry. Child of God, when prayers tarry, affliction prevails. When prayer tarries, delays prevail. When prayers tarry, wickedness prevails. When prayers tarries, delay prevails. It shall not be so for you in the name of Jesus. I prophesy in the name of Jesus upon your life. The baptism to pray, the fire to pray, the grace to pray, the power to pray. Take it in the name of Jesus. Take it in the name of Jesus. Take it in the name of Jesus. Sit down.
Thank you, Jesus.
We now live in a generation where people don't want to pray. I've been releasing prayer fire. They are not picking it up. Hallelujah. They are satisfied where they are. You will never get to where God has ordained you to be until you become a prayer machine. Sir, Jesus was a prayer machine.
Amen.
Jesus, and he said, be imitators. Say, be imitators of Christ. If Jesus prayed for 40 days, 40 nights, you can also pray for 40 days. As a matter of fact, you need to pray double. Because John 14, 12 says that if you believe what happens, the things that Jesus did, you will also do it, and even greater things shall you do. So if Jesus prayed for 40 days and healed the sick and raised the dead, you will pray for more because you are operating in the realm of double grace.
Amen.
So if you want to do double the things that Jesus did, you must pray double to get those things. Hallelujah.
Amen.
People want to see power, but they have no prayer life. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Today you see someone pray for 20 minutes shouting, where is the Lord God of my Father? Where is the pray 20 minutes at he's shouting? He shouts like Elisha. Where is the Lord? 20 minutes prayer that day. Where is the Lord God? That's why the disciples, they went out and they were casting, devils were defeating them big time. They said, Master, what is your secret? Once they even came back to ask the master, he's already praying. As soon as he came out, he said, you losing now, totally lose. Why? Because of the power he acquired. That challenge that is looking at you, it is because you have not separated yourself to pray. Because once you separate yourself to pray, you will get open heavens and you'll get direction. Sir, you're ready. God will give you a solution. Why is it that every time you want to pray, that's when unnecessary distractions, unnecessary phone calls, unnecessary communication. Someone will just knock at your door, say, I just wanted to greet you. Disappear in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Greet me only on the day I want to pray. When you are watching movie, nobody passes around. Even as you are watching, nobody passes around. Even the fly, you know, you are so focused on the movie, watching. Shout hallelujah. Luke 6:12, it says, and it came to pass in those days that he went out into the mountain to pray, and he continued all night in prayer. Jesus, the Son of God. He did not say, no, my father is a governor, I don't need to walk. He said, no, I must walk my money. He said, even though my father is the one that answers prayer, I have to pray to be able to access open heavens. So the heavens were not open upon him because he was the Son of God, but because he prayed. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In any professional competition, child of God, you do not just appear without being prepared. They will so box you. You will fall down, they will follow you on the floor, box you, because you have no energy, because you are not prepared. That's why every time I call the pastors here and I tell them, I say, you are joking with something colossal, something massive. Having a, as we stand on here, we are getting to a point where there will be wickedness on the, in the crowd. You know now the demon, they've gone digital. A witch does not need to go to an altar to afflict you. He just looks at your belly. Oh, so you are pregnant. Just that look, pregnancy disappear. I've heard it again and again and again. They've gone digital, and we are yet joking with our lives and the life of our children. And heavenlies will go to a graveyard for 7 days, no food, no water. What is he looking for? Power. When it says 7 days fast, 10 o'clock we are eating already. 20 minutes prayer. Thank you, Jesus. We are going to bed. And we wonder why that witch is still seeing us in the dream. We wonder why they can still call our name on satanic mirrors and we are, this is how we are praying.
Hey!
You call my name, only fire that will catch in that mirror. Hallelujah. Why? Preparation. Preparation. You see there, you hear testimonies. You, as soon as a testimony comes, those demons fighting that person, they come to me. Most of them, I'll call some of you and say, this is what I saw. This is what I saw. They'll come to try. That's what they do. How can I see? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Anytime you are an usher, you are a choir member, there's someone eyeing in the crowd so you can sing. They are gauging your voice. They don't need to go to an altar to convoke your name. They've gone digital, ma. They've gone digital. They can just say, oh, have you not heard it yet? People lost their voices there. You think it's normal? It's not normal. Someone has stood and said, this voice, I silence it. But there are some people, as soon as they call their name on an altar, fire appears. Hallelujah.
Amen.
After now, anywhere your name is being called, fire will settle the matter in the name of Jesus. Many of you say, I don't have time, but you have time to sleep, you have time to eat. In fact, when you want to eat, you take your time. You hug that food world, you dish it world, you sit down on the sofa world, you take sometimes 1 hour just to prepare that food. But sometimes when it comes to 20 minutes, you're over. Morning devotion, 20 minutes. So morning devotion is just to say, God, thank you. It's not full prayer, but heavens are closed. Morning devotion is saying, God, I thank you for the prayers I pray from 1 to 6.
Yes.
Morning devotion, forget prayer point, no. Lord, I thank you. As I'm going out today, protect me. Bless me. Cover my children. Blood of Jesus, plead over my spirit, my soul, and my body. You take time to do other things. You settle down. You sit down. You watch movie 3 hours. You stop on the phone for 3 hours. That's deliverance. But you cannot pray for 3 hours. You don't have time to pray for 3 hours. When you start praying, as a matter of fact, you are sleeping. 20 minutes, you are asleep. Hallelujah. After now, the prayer fire is falling on someone here in the mighty name of Jesus. Child of God, as around now, fervent, effectual prayer will always sharpen your spiritual antenna to receive signals in the realm of the supernatural. That's why I can text you at 1 a.m. Every one of you have done that. And say, pray now. I said, this is what I see. This is what I see. Pray now. What was I doing? I was praying. Sometimes I was reading my Bible and God would give me the signals. Prayer is important for your next level. Whatever you get by prayer, you must also keep it by prayer. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody said to me the other day, Pastor, must we pray that much? I said, yes, sir. Because whether you know it or not, we live in a wicked world. Child of God, open your Bibles to 1 John 5:19. Let's read. We live in a wicked world, child of God. Are we there? 1 John 5:19. Yeah, that's it. Let's read. It says, and we know that we are of God, and the whole world
lies
where? Even the Bible knows that if only some of us don't know that the whole world lies in wickedness. The whole world lies in wickedness. Wicked world where a man can kill all his children, kill his wife, kill the firstborn, kill everyone or courtesy for money. Who now should eat the money after that? The whole world lies in wickedness. A generation where a witch can kill you anyhow, and many of us are sleeping anyhow, eating anything uneatable. I heard of a story of a girl who was a witch and she acquired great power. And that day she came to church. You know, there are people who are witches, they don't know blind witches. So she came to church and she sat down and she was still in the realm of the power she acquired. She said to herself, let me test the pastor with this new evil power I've acquired. She just looked at the pastor. The pastor was on the floor. And she said, hey, I did not know you would kill the pastor. They said, what did you do? She said, I was trying to test the power that I acquired from the covenants today. He was eating a ballet. He came to the altar begging. He has loaded for the yam, loaded the goosey soup, finished with that, gather rice, finished with that, gather a whole bread, loaded chocolate and butter inside. And he landed on the altar, and next he was on the floor. So if you can see things in the realm of the spirit, you will soon pray. I'm telling you the truth. Matthew 13:25-30 says, while men slept, what happened? His enemy came and sold tithes among the weak, and he went his way. While men slept. Some of you, we are so satisfied where we are. What is a British passport? Have you not seen people with British passport and they don't have a job? People with British passport and they don't have a child? People with British passport and they don't have a career? People with British passport and they don't have a direction? What is a car? Have you not seen robbers with cars? They don't know their direction. They don't know where they are going. It's not enough. God wants to give you an entire business empire.
Amen.
Get out of your comfort zone. Say never. Get out of your comfort zone. The Bible says, Hannah prayed until she lost her voice. Sarah, what are you talking about? The pastor, I prayed. That's why sometimes I hear testimony. I'm like, you are not serious. I prayed. Hannah prayed and she lost her voice. Thank God for grace. Her voice gave way for her miracle to appear. Or prayer. Many of us don't have altars. No, or anywhere we sit, we are just doing our own thing. No place we can say, I separate myself today. Enough of this challenge. This challenge must give way. I'm not leaving this room until I receive that phone call. I'm not leaving this room until I get that court cancellation. Catherine Kuma will pray 8 hours every day before stepping on the altar daily. I was literally shouting on someone the other day and I said, how can you say you're fasting but not praying? Hey, I'm fasting. I said, how much did you pray today? He said, Pastor, when I wake up in the morning, I pray for 10 minutes. I said, tomorrow, go and gather your, whether it's a bar you're eating, whether it's rice, you're, gather a hot bowl, sit down and eat and go to sleep. Because prayer, fasting without prayer is hunger strike. Say never.
Never.
If you are fasting and you are not praying, you just wasted that day. It's hunger strike. Prayer without fasting without prayer is hunger strike. just eat. Hallelujah. So that's right. Don't kill yourself denying your flesh of what he wants, and you are not praying. It's hunger strike. What you must understand while fasting, what God told me today, is that God does not check the amount of food in your belly, sir. God does not check the worms rumbling in your tummy. No. God checks the word that appears before the throne of grace. God checks the words, the utterances that you make daily in your prayer and your fasting. Not the emptiness of your tummy does not check that one, man. Anyone can go without food. People go without food because they want to lose weight. So nothing strange with that. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Witches go without food. But the difference is they don't pray to the God himself. So when you are fasting and you are praying, if you are fasting and you are not praying, it is hunger strike. He's not interested if you are not eating. He's interested in what you tell him. Say, whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and when you loose on earth shall be loose in heaven. So when you are fasting and you are not binding, you are not releasing spiritual mixer, you wasted that day for nothing.
My God.
You are empowering the devil. Come on, afflict. Say you pray. Hallelujah. God will only therefore take note of your amount of prayers that reaches this throne from you that day before he opens the heaven for you. 2 Chronicles 7:14-16, he said, if my people that are called by my name, my people, God is referring to you and I. He said, if they will humble themselves and pray. So if you are not praying, you are proud. Proud people don't pray. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Daniel 10:2 says, then he said to me, fear not, Daniel, for from the first day that you set your heart to understand and humble yourself before your God, your words were heard. Your what? Not your belly was seen that there was no food there. Your words were heard. A closed mouth is a closed destiny. Your words were heard. What did in the toilet? Look at me. I am Tamale. My wife knows. I am going around the house. I can even be in panty. It does not look at the state of you. It does not look what you are. He hears your voice. The toilet pot is doing its own, you are doing your own, your mouth. That's the kind of competition you need to say. You are doing your own, your mouth. Toilet pot versus my mouth. Let's see who will win this battle. That's why the Bible says, pray at all times. Pray at all seasons. Pray. You know the Bible says, when it pray at all times, when the car is driving up, it's in motion. So every time you in your car, you're praying. You are sick, just say, Pastor, let me just enter your car, you will be healed. Automatic. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So as you are fasting, what spiritual mixer are you releasing to take what belongs to you by fire, by force? And that is why many can fast 91 days, child of God, then nothing changes. Because their mouth was shut, and like I said, a closed mouth is a closed destiny. That is why John the Baptist died like a chicken. His enemies came for him, sir. His mouth was, he could not say anything. He could have just said that now, angels of warfare, fire. He died like a chicken. You think God kills anyone prematurely? Lies. Someone said that Miles Monroe died. God, he knew it. What nonsense. At what age? Hallelujah. God does not. And how can God kill a man in a plane crash? Who's God? That's not my God, sir. Elijah was in the same situation as John the Baptist. He said, fire from heaven be released now. Consume them. 50K fire, consume. Another 50K fire, consume. Another 50K fire, consume. His mouth was open. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout, oh Lord. Release on me now. The fire for prayer. If you are blessed, stand up on your feet. We're running out of time. Let's pray quickly. Maloko tele kete le kete. Lakia kata la kata la kata la kata. Yego kole kete le. See me through. Lord Jesus, see me through. See me through. Lord Jesus, see me through. Jesus. So you can't live in bitterness, in anger, in malice, in hatred, and you think it will just work for you like that. Hallelujah. So please leave this place with a commitment to be true. To be true to your calling. To be true to the purpose that God has called you. The life of millions are dependent on some of us. But until we come real, until we come true with God, nothing really happens. Open your mouth, pray for mercy. Whatever may have done that is not right before Him, Lord, mercy. He said, be holy even as I'm holy. Malekata, pray for mercy. Father, have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us. Malekata. Mercy, Lord. I don't want, I'm so positive. I heard God clearly about this service tonight. I am positive that miracles will happen in this service. I'm positive that supernatural finances will be released this month. Open your mouth and pray for mercy. Lord, I refuse to live here the same. I refuse to be a reproach to heaven. I refuse to fail heaven. Help me, oh Lord. Jesus, help me. 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 Makia kata. Le kokote le kete. Le kokote le kete le kete. Maria kata la kata. Thank you, my Father. We bless you, Lord. In Jesus' name we are praying. Your amen is looking for my trouble. Stretch your hands to the anointing oil. Pray for fire. Let the fire of God enter it now. As you lay your hands on that anointing oil, as you anoint yourself, as I anoint you later on, let your heavens be perpetually open. Open, open, open all throughout this year. Open your mouth and pray for that anointing oil. Father, transform it in the blood of Jesus. That fire of God, enter that oil now. Let that oil be transformed into the fire of God. Let that oil right now be transformed into demon crushing oil. Anything he touches that is out of God, let there be an opportunity in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and begin to pray that prayer. Lakia kata lakata. Leko sepa lakata. Leko kore kete lekete. Let the anointing that brings the young be infused in that oil. I declare, I declare. I convey that oil into oil healing in the name of Jesus. I convey that oil into oil deliverance. I convey that oil into oil speed. I convey that oil into oil of restoration. I convey that oil into living waters in the name of Jesus. And I declare that whoever uses that oil, oh Lord, let them be part of any evil contamination in the name of Jesus. Jesus, the same angel that's shaking the pool of Bethesda, let that same angel shaking that oil now for miracles, for breakthroughs, for supernatural visitations, for supernatural encounters, for next level blessings in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth. Pray, 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 pray. Precious Holy Spirit of God, charge this oil into your fire. Charge this oil into your fire. Charge this oil into your fire. Convert it in the blood of Christ. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord. We celebrate you, Lord. We rejoice you, Lord. In Jesus' name we are praying. Let's all take a bit of that oil now. Do that in faith. And when I say put it on your forehead, put it on your forehead, that oil you're holding in your hand, it becomes the oil of fire. I decree as you put it on your forehead, when I say you should do anything in that life that is not of Christ, it shall give way to your miracles. In the name of Jesus. Put it on your forehead if you have got it and begin to speak in tongues. When I say pray, I will tell us what to pray. Put it on your forehead. Thank you, Holy Ghost, for all you have said to do in this place tonight. Thank you for the testimonies galore that are coming for right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, mighty holy angels of healing, of deliverance, of signs, of wonders. Oh, thank you for going ahead all over this meeting. Power of God. Look at that brother, look at that sister, for a miracle, for a testimony, for high favor in the name of Jesus. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Where is that brother? Disconnect them from the foundation of their father's house. Disconnect that sister from the foundation of their father's house. Anything in them that is not of you, by the anointing that destroys them, let that yoke be destroyed now. Holy Ghost, locate them now. Holy Ghost, locate them now. Say with me, Father, in the name of Jesus. Say with me, Father, in the name of Jesus. As my head is anointed tonight with oil, I decree and I declare that my cup will run over. Every yoke is therefore broken. Every burden is lifted. Every weight is pulled down by fire. In the name of Jesus, I declare and I declare, as my head is anointed now, I shall arise and shine all throughout this year and beyond, from glory to glory, from blessing to blessing, from miracle to miracle, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, by this anointing oil, I lose every chain of sin, I lose every chain of witchcraft, I lose every chain of shame, I lose every chain of disgrace, I lose every evil comments. In the name of Jesus, shout, I break. I lose myself from every arrow, from my father's house, from my mother's house, I reverse them back to sender, by fire, by thunder, in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and begin to pray that prayer. Everywhere my head will go from now, it will attract favor, it will attract my helpers. Open your mouth and pray. Lakata, lakata, lakata. Thank you, Father. We bless you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Amen. We shall anoint our hands. As you get anointed, rub it on your two hands. That's what I'll do later on. But you have a part to play. I have a part to play. Go around, give them. Just be big. You don't need to put much. As you take it, you rub it on your two hands. You rub it on your two hands as you pray. Go on this side, Pastor David, go on this side. Maria Kata Lakata. Lego Kote Lekete. Lego Kore. If you still have some on your hands, that's fine. You don't need to take. Maria Kata. Pray. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I declare and declare that from today, that anything that is anointed hands will touch, it will prosper in the name of Jesus. It will prosper in the name of Jesus. It will prosper in the name of Jesus. Say, I declare in the name of Jesus, anything that is dead, that is will touch, it will jack back to life. It will jack back to life. It will jack back to life. In the name of Jesus, say, I declare and declare that all throughout this year and beyond, my hands become hands of fire, become hands of healing, become hands of deliverance, become hands of breakthrough. In the name of Jesus, I declare and declare that from now, anything my hands will touch, it will receive high favor. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and begin to pray that prayer. Speak to your hands. 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 Make declaration. The Bible says we shall decree a thing and it shall be established. Anything that hand will touch after now, the favor of God, the favor of God, the blessings of God. Anything that has died before, as I come back home by this encounter, as I lay my
Thank you.
Jesus. For the anointing that destroys it all. Some of you will be taken away from the foundation of your father's house. Sudden visitations, Lord. Sudden encounters, Lord of Father. Sudden manifestations, supernatural manifestation of people. In the name of Jesus, angels of prayer and ministry. Take up your breath in the name of Jesus. Visit them, O Lord. Visit them, O Lord, in their sleep. Visit them, O Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Somebody, I heard it clearly, you are receiving direction in the name of Jesus. Somebody, you are receiving direction in the name of Jesus. Amen. Let's take a communion. Stretch your hands, we don't have the time. Stretch your hands, pray for the communion. Transform it into the blood of Jesus. Transform it to 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 the blood of Jesus. This is the last card. This is the last joker. Whatever may have escaped the sword of Elijah, it will not escape the sword of Jehu. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and pray. And it says they are three. That very weakness. Their blood, their oil, and the water. Lord, it says, and the three are three. Father, as they take of the blood and the body of Christ tonight, Jesus, whatever may have escaped by the communion tonight, let that thing that is not of you be uprooted in the name of Jesus. By this communion, take them out of their father's house. 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 By this communion, let delays be broken. Let delays be broken. Let delays be destroyed. My dear Gata, la Gata, la Gata. Let dream manipulation be canceled. Let dream manipulation be terminated. Anything that appears in their dream, spiritual husband, spiritual wife, married husband, married wife, everyone that's with the family spirit, by this communion, to get back to your name in the name of Jesus. You said, oh Lord, that they shall lie down, and their sleep shall be sweet to your glory. Therefore, I declare that by this communion, let their sleep be sweet to your glory after now. Let their sleep be sweet to your glory. Let their sleep be sweet to your glory. Thank you, my Father. Jesus, mighty name we are praying. It is blessed in the name of Jesus. On the night that Jesus was betrayed, he stood in the upper room to the disciples. He took the bread that represented his body. After he has blessed it and given thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, take of this and eat. This is my body that was broken for you on the cross of Calvary for the remission of your sins. He said, do this as often as you can until my coming in remembrance of me. Amen. In the same order of event, after they may have eaten of his body, he took the cup that represented his blood. After he has blessed and given thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, take of this and drink. This cup is my blood of the new covenant that was shed for you on the cross of Calvary for the remission of your sins. He said to them, do this as often as you can until my coming in remembrance of me. Amen. Please take that prayer fully. You can take it, you don't need to eat it immediately. You can pray the prayer again. Let it enter your system and destroy everything there that is not planted by you. name of Jesus. I decree no more pains in their body. I decree no more affliction. I decree no more nightmares. In the name of Jesus. Thank you. those hands to Jesus. Tell him something good. Thank you, my Father. We bless you. We celebrate you for tonight. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Stretch your hands to the altar. Let me release you with the blessing. Father, in the name of Jesus, as you have commanded me tonight, so I have done. Jesus, let this be evident with testimonies like never seen before in the name of Jesus. I prophesy wherever you are right now, thou art made whole in the name of Jesus. In your finances, in your business, in your marriage, in the works of your hands, thou art made whole in the name of Jesus. I put a seal on every prayer you have prayed tonight and for the past 57 days in the name of Jesus. I decree whatever the enemy has launched to kill answers to your prayer, it scatters by this encounter in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I release you to go now into strange favor in the name of Jesus. I release you to go into strange encounters in the name of Jesus. I release you to go into strange restorations in the name of Jesus. Some of you looking at me now, you will walk on the street after now, and favor will come and meet you in the name of Jesus. I declare in the name of Jesus, every abnormality in your life, in your family, I command it be revealed in the name of Jesus. I don't know where you are right now, but the God of this commission will surprise you after now in the name of Jesus. I declare and declare by the power of the Holy Ghost that the next high level accomplishment of your life, it will be without struggle in the name of Jesus. It will be without sweat in the name of Jesus. I prophesy in the name of Jesus, every human agent standing against your prophetic fulfillment, maternal, paternal, I command them to bow in the name of Jesus. I decree whatever has caused you tears before, I decree it comes to an end in the name of Jesus. I turn every test to testimonies in the name of Jesus. I turn every delay to speed in the name of Jesus. I cancel court cases in the name of Jesus. I judge them in your favor in the name of Jesus. I cancel negative medical report in the name of Jesus. Anywhere you were rejected before, be accepted in the name of Jesus. Any door that was closed to you before, I command you open in the name of Jesus. Go and take over in the name of Jesus. Go and win in the name of Jesus. Someone here, you must have an outstanding testimony in the name of Jesus. If that is you, let your amen be loudest. If that is you, let your amen be loudest. If that is you, let your amen be loudest. So shall it be in Jesus' name. Wave your hands, thank him. Thank him, thank him, thank him. Father, we just thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. Blessed is he that believeth, for there shall be a performance. My brother there, just when I was watching his feet last time, I asked him about a particular document he submitted. He said he has not come. But today I asked him again, has he come? After feet washing, he has handed it to his hand. Celebrate Jesus. Celebrate Jesus. So that is to tell you that what you have done today, we have not just wasted time here. The feet washing, I received about two or three testimonies. Many of you have not said anything. But that is one proof there that you are seeing. So as you have come today, you are going back with proofs in the name of Jesus. I say you are going back with proofs in the name of Jesus. What others will be struggling to get in 5 years, take it in 5 days in the name of Jesus. Take it in 5 hours in the name of Jesus. This week your phone will ring for favor in the name of Jesus. If that is you, shout amen like thunder. Go in peace and return back with your testimonies in the name of Jesus. Let me hear 7 thunderous amen. Grace and grace. grace of our Lord Jesus Christ,
the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us
all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the presence of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. I tell you what I feel this morning. Whether you like it or not, testimonies will locate you. Go to someone and say, congratulations, congratulations. Good night, congratulations. There's no house fellowship tomorrow, remember? No house fellowship tomorrow.
Ladies, please, can we quickly help with the cleaning?
The next week, from Monday to Friday, is our deliverance services.